the following contest, it is set for one fall. Introducing first, from the WCW Special Forces, he's a member of the Patriots, Firebreaker Jeff. And wrestling fans, his opponent. He will be accompanied by Paul E. Dangerously. From Provincedale, Minnesota, weighing 254 pounds, Ravishing Rick Boone.
Here we
cut
go.
The music. What I'd like to have right now is for all you fat, out of shape, Georgia germ spreaders, keep the noise down while I take my robe off and show you what a real man is supposed to look like. Hit the music.
Heavyweight champion Ravishing Rick Rude preparing to do battle with Firebreaker Chip, who, as you can see, has got an injured right knee. Ravishing Rick Rude should feel right at home facing a man with a bad knee. That is indeed how he became the U.S. Heavyweight Champion, when he faced Ravishing Rick Rude at the Clash of Champions. Collar and elbow hookup in the center of the ring, into a top wrist lock now on Firebreaker Chip. Chip with a very low center of gravity, tremendous upper body strength, able to get underneath his opponents, just like we saw there. Into that escape now, Ravishing Rick Rude with a reversal. Chip with an elbow to the face. Side headlock now, having to reach a little bit for that headlock. Takes the U.S. Heavyweight Champion over. And you can see Ravishing Rick Rude now with that cross face, able to keep some distance between himself and his opponent. I'd like to see the WCW keep some distance between Paulie Dangerously and ringside, but unfortunately for everyone concerned, Paulie Dangerously does indeed possess a manager's license, which qualifies him to be at ringside. Firebreaker Chip maintaining control of this contest with that side headlock, but giving up some reach advantage. You can see he's having a difficult time holding on to it. Again, Ravishing Rick Rude now with a cross face, goes down low, single leg pickup. He's gonna drop him on his good knee. Fans, just a reminder, coming up, it is Starrcade weekend. Still, time left for you to contact your local cable company. Tell them that you wanna be a part of Starrcade 91 Battle Bowl, the Lethal Lottery. It is indeed a pay-per-view exclusive. And what a way to finish 1991. The Lethal Lottery. 40 athletes put together at random to create 20 tag teams. Nobody knows who their partner is going to be. Will we see Ravishing Rick Rude and Firebreaker Chip as tag team partners? Or let's take it a step further. Ravishing Rick Rude, look at this. Pile driver now on Chip. Will we see Ravishing Rick Rude and Sting as partners? Two count, Chip kicks out. Twenty teams fighting it out. And then the winning teams, 10 teams, will then go on to phase two of Battle Bowl. It'll be 20 men facing each other one-on-one in a two-ring battle royal to find out who is the toughest of the top, who is going to be be declared the winner of Battle Bowl. What's going to happen if and when the Dangerous Alliance have to face each other in competition? Let's face it. With Ravishing Rick Rude, Arn Anderson, Larry Zbyszko, Beautiful Bobby, and Stunning Steve, all members of the Dangerous Alliance involved in this situation, odds are that they're going to have to face each other in competition. Will that destroy the allegiance, the alliance? Will the Dangerous Alliance come apart at the seams? We'll find out this weekend. Ravishing Rick Rude now. Snapmare takeover. Reverse base lock now on Firebreaker Chip.
Come on.
What's going to happen if Scott Steiner and Rick Steiner have to face each other? This just occurred to me. Can you imagine that? Scott Steiner, Rick Steiner facing each other, the last two men in the ring of the Battle Royal. What do? They're brothers. Oh, fans, you don't want to miss it, whatever you do. I know I'm looking forward to it. It's Ravishing Rick Rude now sets Firebreaker Chip up for the Rude Awakening, and he delivers. There's your winner.
Ladies and gentlemen, the winner of the match, Ravishing Rick Rude.
There's a pile driver that really softened Firebreaker Chip up. Set him up for the Rude Awakening. We'll be back.